Hello everyone. Today, we're going to introduce a very mysterious model called Nano Banana. Why do we call this model mysterious? Just a few days ago, while we were marveling at the powerful image editing capabilities of Qwen Image Edit, many people noticed a mysterious model quietly climbing the image editing model rankings, and its ranking was very high. Many speculated that Google was behind this model, but this rumor had not been confirmed. We have to admit, this model's image editing capabilities are indeed a level higher than all other models in the same category. Through this model, we can achieve astonishing results. For example, it offers excellent costume changes. Even with complex clothing, we can precisely change it to the desired attire. Similarly, it has powerful capabilities in the image editing domain. Here are some of its impressive capabilities. Given an image, we can edit it freely, according to our needs. We can change the environment to a beautiful night scene. We can transform a woman's hair into a pretty short hairstyle. It can even alter the perspective to a top-down view. Many models cannot achieve such excellent perspective changes, but Nano Banana can indeed handle these challenging tasks. Furthermore, its performance and character consistency is also excellent. We can take an old photo and turn the person into a modern character, placing them in front of the Forbidden City to create a beautiful snow scene photos. For the same person, we can make them travel through decades to generate two different photos, and the overall performance is outstanding. Some have also used it to modify YouTube covers. Nano Banana can also be used to create virtual digital humans to showcase specified products. If you have strong video generation capabilities, you can also use Nano Banana to create images and then produce high-quality videos.
我以为大学毕业就能有未来，可是现在投出去的简历都没有回应，每一天的沉默越来越沉重。别人说。Similarly,
it can also be used to create creative videos for products, such as handbags. These are some of the effects we've seen from Nano Banana, which I believe are truly impressive. It is indeed different from traditional image editing models. Now, let's reveal the answer everyone is curious about. Is Nano Banana related to Google? Of course, it is. A few days ago, Nano Banana was officially renamed Gemini 2.5 Flash Image Preview. You can now use this model on Gemini AI Studio LM Arena. Generally, this model is paid. However, there are currently two ways to use it for free. The first way is on Google's AI Studio. In the model selection list on the right, you can see a new model, which is the Gemini 2.5 Flash Image Preview we just mentioned. When you switch to this model, you'll see a similar prompt indicating that the model is currently free for a limited time. So, using it on this interactive interface is currently free of charge. Alternatively, you can use this model on LM Arena. This platform was also one of the first to allow the use of Nano Banana. At that time, it was mainly used in model versus model comparisons, where models were randomly assigned for generation, and Nano Banana was one of them. Currently, you can directly select and use this model within the chat interface. To help everyone understand the advantages of this model more clearly, I won't conduct typical tests here. Our first test is still generating Lora training datasets, as I previously performed a similar experiment on Qwen Image Edit. You can find detailed information about building this workflow in this video. First, we have a reference image. Then, using Qwen Image and its character consistency feature, we used 12 relatively realistic prompts to generate 12 images. The results of these 12 images are generally good. However, there are some critical flaws, such as distortion of the character's body structure. In full body shots, the overall structure of the character is disproportionate. Additionally, the facial appearance still has a noticeable greasy feel, resembling some text-to-image characteristics. What if we had Nano Banana perform the same task? Let's take a look. On the LM Arena website, I used the same 12 prompts. Note that the reference image and the prompts are identical. Look at the results of the images we generated. Firstly, character consistency is much better. Secondly, the environmental representation. Consistency with prompts. The realism and natural feel of the characters and the proportions of the human body all far surpass Qwen Image Edit. If only one image looked like this, we might call it an exception. But if all 12 images look this way, we can only conclude that there is a fundamental difference in the model's capabilities. If you're interested, you can try it out. Here, I need to emphasize that each time you generate an image, you should re-upload the reference image. Although the website is called chat, referring to a chat window, its contextual semantic understanding is not very strict. Therefore, when you want it to refer to a specific image, it's best to re-upload it. Otherwise, it might not understand your intent. Next, let's do some more tests. Again, on the LM Arena platform, because it's free, as I mentioned, we'll skip conventional tests. Let's look at this image. It's a woman in a night scene, so the overall image is dark, and there's a bokeh effect from distant neon lights. My current prompt is, make the scene to daytime, meaning to convert it to a daytime scene. You'll notice that its reasonableness and the overall aesthetic of the image are excellent. First, there shouldn't be neon lights during the day, so it doesn't just remove the neon bokeh. Instead, the entire lighting effect is gone. The overall color perception, including the preservation of details, there's a watermark, which is also present in the original image, though perhaps not very clear. The character's clothes, facial expression, posture, and the environment's depiction are all very impressive. For the second test, let's look at perspective change. Here's a beautiful image of a woman sitting on a chair, with bowls, plates, and a water glass beside her. The prompt I wrote is very simple, from above, meaning to view the image from a top-down perspective. You'll find this very interesting. The character appears to be slightly facing upwards. You'll notice that the state of the chair remains consistent with the reference image, and the character's posture is also consistent. Of course, from a top-down view, you might wonder if there's an issue with the hand, which is hard to say. But you'll notice that in terms of overall details, the character's clothing and the arrangements, there's a cup, a bowl, a plate, and even a spoon that we might not have noticed before. So we can see that it indeed possesses very strong expressive power and image reconstruction capabilities. Similarly, let's do an experiment in AI Studio. I have an image of a woman, and I want her face to be clearer. So, I want a close-up. My first prompt was, make a close-up view of this girl, meaning we want a closer view of the woman who is currently in a full-body shot. You'll see that it became a half-body shot, and the face became clearer. However, I felt it wasn't clear enough, so I changed the prompt again, to make an extreme close-up view of this girl, asking for an even clearer image. As you can see, I now have a very clear face. I can then use this face to generate more data or train Lora. Through these examples from online experts and our own practical tests, we can see that Nano Banana's capabilities are indeed not to be underestimated. However, it's undeniable that this is a closed-source model. Thus, open-source and closed-source models are always competing and improving each other. I believe that soon, we will also have similar open-source models. The reason is simple. The emergence of closed-source models means they can provide even more powerful datasets for open-source models. Once data is available, open-source models can be trained to achieve similar results. That's all for today. Follow me to become someone who understands AI.